Hello world. Welcome to Joe Sharma Talk Show. I'm your host, Joe Sharma, actress producer from San Francisco, USA. This new unique global talk show telecasted by TV5 India, Mana TV USA, all over the world. Every week with your favorite celebrities and famous personalities. Welcome to Joe Sharma Talk Show, live from San Francisco, Bay Area, California. Today, we are going to have a special celebrity guest, which we are going to introduce a little later. But before that, this is going to be live telecasted in TV5 in India, Mana TV in the United States, and all over the world. So stay tuned. This is the best show for all filmmakers. You have to watch today's show. Bhargav Garu, Mire Nandi.
Yeah.
My movie got stuck in between, and I heard you're the person who really helps anyone, anything gets stuck. Like you were helping somebody in Gautam movie with their car stuck. Can you please help me with my movie? It's really stuck, Bhargav.
Absolutely. You come to the right person. Why don't you sit down? Let's have a coffee and talk about it.
Yay, awesome. There you go, guys. This is Bhargav, and we are going to have a special show with him today with the talk show. Hi, Bhargav. How are you?
Hi, Joe. Doing very good. How are you? And thanks for that warm welcome. It was great.
So while drinking, sipping coffee, virtual coffee, we are going to have a lot of conversation with you. The special conversation with all our audience are so eager to listen from your point of view as an actress to an actor and producer. We are so excited for this, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. So I'm going to come up with some routine questions, which you might have answered in 100 interviews, but it's still okay. We need to have some routine questions before we go to our specialized segments. How did you get into movies?
This is a routine question, I guess, after having done quite a few interviews after Gautam.
In short. So,
I think, I guess, I had this acting bug as from my childhood, right? I used to watch movies, come back, imitate the actors, imitate the accents, even English movies, right? A South African accent or a Southern drawl, if you will. You know,
South
all these kind of
accent. Oh my God! Now yeah, South African,
or you know, in Texas or a Southern Alabama drawl, if you will, right? And you know, not and and many Hindi and Telugu movies as well, right? I used to imitate and come back and, like, you know, really bug my parents and my brother, if you will. So it started there, but then I, while in college, I did my engineering in North from Dhanbad. I acted in many dramas, went to many youth festivals, did win quite a few. So it was always there. But then after I started working, I'm in IT right now. It went dormant for a while. And then in 2015, by happenstance, I chanced to meet Kiran, right, who used to play cricket for me in my cricket team, etc. So one thing led to another. We started making short films because of I had the bug, and he had the bug as well. He had been doing films since 2012. So, you know, one thing led to another. Our first short film actually won quite a few awards. So that short film.
What's the name of that short film?
It's called A Winter to Remember.
Okay, it's in English.
It's in English and mostly in English, just like Gautam, right? A lot of English and a little bit of Telugu.
Got it.
But that's the main plot we took and made it into Gautam today. So that's how, my journey into film.
Awesome. This is so inspiring because, you know, so many aspiring actors and directors and all the people, it's all about all that one chance they get to make it to that big success. And that destiny decides, like, you know, sometimes you have the right people in the right place. And I'm sure it's not an easy thing. I'm sure everyone agrees to that nothing is easy in this life to achieve, right?
Yep.
So I know this Gautam has happened with being done in the United States. Anything to be done here is very challenging because of less number of resources, you know, limited budget scenarios. And we cannot just survive with movie as it is, like people like me or anyone here. We need to have our regular jobs and then have this passion thing going to survive here.
Absolutely.
So how did you, keeping that in mind, how did your journey started with pulling in people together, because team is everything, right? Team is everything. And when you're not famous, it's a much bigger problem. When you're famous, yeah, everyone lines up, take me. But the initial stage is the toughest. So tell me your journey on how did you find your team?
You're right. I mean, it's very tough, especially we are working, you know, IT. 90% of the team, 95% of the team were in IT. Right, Kiran, my director, is in IT. Associate director, IT. I myself am in IT. Everybody is in IT. Right, even the my other co-star, Rakesh, is in IT. You know, so first knowing people through your friend's circle was very important. So how we made this film, right? How we made it work for so many IT professionals was, we took a chunk. The first schedule was like 15 days. We shot it in Tahoe in December during the holiday.
Did you all take vacation and then just say that, okay, it's a family vacation?
Most of us took 2 weeks off.
Okay.
But that was 14 days. And we had another 12 days to shoot. So we spread that across weekends. For the next like 6 weekends, we spread it. Okay. So continuous weekends, right? We'll wait for 2-3 weeks. One weekend, another, like, you know, wait a few more weeks and then another weekend. So we made it work so that everybody could fly in and have enough time and prepare, etc., etc. So that's how we overall shooting span wise, we started December, we finished it in September. But total shooting days, if you will, only 26 days.
Wow. That brings up one point. I totally agree to you. When I did my first shooting, I had to go for a month to Mumbai and Hyderabad. And I totally agree with you that the pre-production of the movie was done 2.5 years, where the directors, scriptwriters, DOP, they were all breaking their head. And I was so lucky that I stepped in literally one day, like, you know, 2-3 days before, because they just auditioned and they just liked me and they had to pull me in into a lead role. So I understand the drill that I am one of the lucky, in a way, to step in 3 days before. But all the people who are working hard for 2 years on that, It's a major task for them. So everyone will be like, you know, oh, do you guys just shoot for like 15 days to 1 month? That's it? I thought the movie making takes like you shoot and shoot for 3 years. I said, no, that's not true. So I'm glad you're picking that same point, which I keep telling to people, that it's not the movie shooting that takes 3 years. It's the movie making process that takes 2 to 3 years. So, so thanks for highlighting that decision. Coming to your acting, right? You are a bomb. I mean, you were the best in the movie. I'm sure, hands down, everyone will agree to it. It's a known fact, all right?
Thank you.
How do you feel about your craft? Because I'm sure, as you were saying, that Kiran and you are done this before and you have created a short film. And then from there, you got the inspiration for this full-fledged. And there's one person I'm sure Kiran would have like taken you as the main character to build on, right? But that character is a very complicated character. What you played is not that easy one, right? To look like a bad guy is different, but to convince somebody that your looks actually deceived, it felt like you were actually a really good guy, all right? And that current shock when you turn your characterization to something else, it was like, whoa, I didn't expect that. How did you pull that off? I mean, like, you know, that characterization of, how did you pull that off? If you can share something for the aspiring actors, they would love to listen from you. That
I don't know if you can learn from another actor. I really doubt it. Maybe there are, like, you know, maybe there is like about 20-30% of acting which is base, which is stock acting, right? I mean, you know, everybody does that probably. But acting for me is something, you know, obviously there will be some type of acting that I probably am not natural at and cannot do it easily. Everybody has that. I do have blocks, many blocks in while shooting time. But for me, it's more natural, right? I have to have a feel for it. So when I'm in that particular moment, I actually feel what I'm doing. Like, you know, if I'm going for something bad, like, you know, maybe, you know, breaking somebody's arm or hitting him, I actually get that feeling. If I'm in real life, if somebody has killed my daughter, I don't think I will leave anything in the tank when I will try to hit him. right? So I'll get all of that anger. And, you know, it's a very natural thing that happens. I don't prepare, and I never prepared much. That's one of the things that Kiran, you know, sometimes is afraid about me, is like, I, even 2 seconds before the shot, I'm not in the mood. I'm basically joking off, loafing, you know, pranks and cranks and whatnot. I'm laughing, but I am able to just channelize at that moment. So it just happens naturally to me. But after Gatham, right? After Gatham, I've seen the product. I felt, oh, maybe if I prepared more for it, right? I could have killed it. Because, you know, only I know where I could have done more, right?
More.
Maybe.
You know your strengths and yes.
Yeah. So, you know, I think preparing for a role is very important. I believe that. But for Gatham, it was very natural for me. You know, God's grace or whatever, I was able to pull it off. But I, you know, did in the initial phase, we had workshops and all. We'd spent time. I mean, it's not like, you know, totally, you know, I saw the script and let's go shooting. It's not like that.
Yes, we did.
I practiced it. Like for me, emotion is not easy. Okay, crying and all, they don't come easy for me.
Killing emotion does come.
that's easy, right? I mean, you've seen so many, you're a boy, you know, you've seen all this, you want to fight as a kid and all that. But probably that's already of the easy for me, right? So, but this whole daughter emotion and getting it out, crying and all that, I practiced that. I used to call Kiran up and say, I'm in the plane, right? At Q, I got tears in my eyes. So I would get off the plane. I'll call Kiran up and say, hey, you know, I did this. I was able to cry. I think we're ready.
Nice. So it's basically, let's conclude that getting into the character, right? That is all what it means. Like, you know, I think the minute you say shot, like, you know, when the camera, like, you know, when you're ready, the director gives the cue, is the actor's intuition of switching on and off, being on screen and off screen, you know, the category.
What you said before, preparation is very key. A lot, spend as much time preparing for it. Actually, on the day of the set, you probably don't need to worry too much, right? But preparing, so getting into your character, the ease you get into your character is dependent on how much you have prepared.
How much work we do before. Yeah, perfect. So how much planning did this movie went into? Because as I said, when you're just coming into the picture, doing big things, everything is a challenge. Like finding a team, you know, producers, actors, casting, everything is a challenge. And until the movie is done, we keep our fingers crossed. Like, you know, that every step is like keeping the fingers crossed. How much planning did you guys do? And especially any challenges that you faced with the planning and casting and all, like from your perspective?
Planning is the key. And I think I mentioned it in many of my interviews. It's something that goes against our grains as Indians, I guess. Right. We're very good at thinking, you know, thinking on the spur of the moment. We are problem solvers. So I think we excel at becoming problem solvers rather than being great program managers, you know. But I think this art cries out loud for being a great program manager. And before Gatham, right, for Gatham, when we were doing it, we really spent a lot of time. Okay, we believe we spent a lot of time. We did the best planning we could do. In retrospect, I would at least spend twice or three times the amount of time we spent for Gatham, which is considerable. Wow. But now knowing what I know now, I would have done that, and I would easily shave off. I would like to say 10-15% of the my cost. You know.
Wow, I know you played a part as a producer too. So your involvement into Gatham is not just as an actor. You worked too hard for it. Because as a producer, when you're getting into this kind of big world, every penny counts. At the same time, you cannot compromise on the quality of the product as well, right? So it's a tough decision making. How much did you involve in decision making? Because there are two types of producers, which I always see. One set of producers in typical industry where they put the money and the director takes care of everything. But there are another set of producers where they involve in the movie making too, because every penny counts, and it's for, in order to get convinced what is right, what is wrong, you need to understand your project so thoroughly that you make the right decision and right call, right? And director really appreciates that kind of producers around. So I want to understand, what type of producer are you? I can already guess, but I want you to say that.
Yeah, I mean, to start off, I think I was, I was learning, right? You know, I'm not like, I don't have 30 years in, you know, doing movies, yep. right, or films. So I started off being a little hands-off, if you will, right? Mm-hmm. Because, you need to give space to the other decision makers. I am a very strong decision maker. I am a very strongly convinced person, right? My convictions are super strong. When I set my conviction on something, it'll take a Herculean effort for somebody to change my mind. But I will change if it's valid, right? The argument is valid.
Yes.
That's why I won't make decisions that easily. I do spend some time. So that's why I let people, but as time went on, right, because of some of the lessons we learned in our journey of Gotham, right, I started becoming more hands-on, if you will. Like, for example, the onboarding the music director or a DOP, after Kiran likes someone, or, I would ask Kiran who, given all other things being equal, who do you want the best music director? So he gave me Sri Charan's name. I called up Sri Charan, talked to him, negotiated for 1/4 or like whatever was this thing, right? Really, did whatnot.
You use your charm, whatever it is.
Yeah, it happened for him, right? We were able to onboard other DOPs, right? Other cameramen. It's the same thing, right? Kiran would like someone, then I would talk. No bullshit, right? Go through, all the details as they will face it on the set so that I don't have any, surprises on the day where they come in and they're surprised by, hey, I was only supposed to work this much, no surprises, right? So the ultimate task of making sure that this person will be right on the set, as time went on, I liked doing that part. And going forward, I'm already working on my second film right now. It's a very hands-on job that I'm doing, not just getting the dollars in or the rupees in, but being there as that sounding board for the director, guiding and helping the director through his decisions, making the final call, making sure we're within budget, giving the right guidelines and this constant. I think that goes a long way in making a good movie.
I think with so much of knowledge you're gaining and you already have hands-on, you seem to be ready for directing a movie in the very future. I think you should become a director and direct movies, Bhargav.
I would love to. I think when the time is right, for example, this next movie film that is in the works, right from the script, right, I'm involved. I'll have my name in the script as well. I'm one of the writers.
Very nice.
I'm helping out very closely with all the decision makings of this thing. So I think pretty soon I will definitely, hopefully touch wood, but soon I will do that.
Then I will collaborate with you. However, that's a plan.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So coming to the next thing, do you agree that actors or anything in the entertainment industry, actually anything in life itself is destiny and luck, but especially this particular point comes very close to entertainment field, that destiny, luck adds a lot of points. I mean, we should not say this out blunt, but unfortunately, that's what every actor you ask or anyone, they will outright say that, jo luck to hona chahiye, luck kawali. That's something standard statement a lot of people use. What do you say about that? I mean, talent is required. I'm not even telling about that. Talent, money, all that. Yes, placeholders. But there is another one big question mark in between. What is your idea on that?
I will say yes. However, you have to push luck towards you. So if you give yourself enough chance, put yourself in enough right positions, it might happen. The probability of you happen, right? It's like if you talk about from a statistics point, right? If you're going to stay at your home and imagine you want to become a star, it's not going to happen, right? But if you put yourself through school, acting school, if you put yourself through the paces, you talk to agents, you talk to whatnot, you meet a lot of people, you network, the crap out of everybody, then you're putting yourself in the best possible position to actually be noticed and be lucky. While that is there, luck is, you can do all of that and then not see the light of day. That can happen. But then what's in our control? We don't have control over luck. So what we have in our control is making sure we do the paces. We do the things that are minimum expected and hope, increase the chances, basically.
No, absolutely. That's a great thing that you said. Absolutely, I agree to that. Luck is definitely there, but if you do not give yourself enough chances, the luck does not find you, right? It's kind of like you have to give your enough chances before you declare it that, you know, okay, this is what it is. Absolutely. I'm sure I can see all your hard work really paid off. I know there's a lot of challenges that you might have faced with Gautam, but you guys somehow pull it off. You know, I'm sure you might have a count also. Tell me the count of number of challenges if it is on top of your mind.
I think I said this number quite a few interviews that, you know, I happened to do after Gautam, which is like at least 30 times our film should have stopped.
Wow, 30 times.
Yeah, 30 times. I mean, it's like every day, one or two incidents where, like, you know, we lost our, you know, lenses. We lost lenses close to $100,000. Three lenses, three prime lenses.
$100,000? Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
I would have had a heart attack on producer's mind.
Yes, yes. And I, you know, and that's exactly my mindset was. However, I saw my director down and said, like, you know, Kiran, keep your eyes on the ball. We're going to finish this. Come what way, the movie is not going to stop. You worry about your stuff. You know, we will see what will happen, right? We'll think, take care of it. When the time comes, we'll take care of it. And lo and behold, we were so lucky that the next day, a guy came with our box and said, hey, you know, somebody left it on the road yesterday. It looks like, were you there yesterday? You know, we said, boss, thank you very much.
Oh my God. There you go. That's the luck factor. You guys spread God so much that God is like, okay, you know, these people are working too hard. Let them just have it, make it easy for them.
Throughout Gautam,
yeah,
for any film, right, my advice would be, before you get into making a film or a short film even, right, keep your eyes on two things, right? One is like willpower. Steel. You have to have steel willpower as a director, as a producer, because come what may, life will throw you a curveball. You just have to make sure you deal with it. Okay. So that's one thing, right? The other most important thing is, you know, many times you will not see the way forward. Like, you know, lenses lost, right? What do you do? We only had three telephoto lenses.
Oh my God.
Okay, so I said, okay, let's take the next step only, which is today's shoot. Okay. So we went back, we made those, you know, shots happen. Okay. However, right, and we made those shots happen. Then next day this guy came and gave our prime lenses back, the other lenses back. So you see what I'm saying? So the other thing I tell is, when you don't see the path forward, take the next step. Step after that, and then it will open up. That should be your bullheadedness towards making. You have to be bullheaded when you're going to make a film, otherwise it's not going to work out.
Wow, that's amazing. I mean, it's just giving me chills just hearing that, trust me. I mean, being in that panic mode, finishing the rest of the day shooting, I think that's the toughest part. I can even think, everyone's mind is going on what is going to happen tomorrow.
Yeah,
wow.
Yeah.
Amazing. I mean, that's really amazing. I'm sure you being part of the team would have been such an asset. I mean, you know, Kiran and you, I just cannot imagine two powerhouses, right? When such strong pillars, that's the reason, like many people will say, the pillars have to be strong. Then the house will stand for whatever situations it is in. I can strongly say that I think you and Kiran were really the pillars of this project to push this off.
For sure. But it's a team, right? It takes a village is what I believe. So I think you mentioned it before, and I think you've lived it yourself. The team that you build, the team that you go with, it makes a lot of difference. Harsha is the associate director. He's a workhorse. He's a powerhouse. He's a pillar. You know, one of the main reasons, you know, as much as I credit Kiran with all, you know, whatever that we've done with Gautam, I credit Harsha with that. But then what about Sri Charan's music? What about the editing? Nobody talks about editing. That's the best thing. When nobody talks about editing, then you know what, you know, it's, you're telling I acted well, right? Well, I acted well. I did well only because the editor showed me.
Told you well.
You know what I'm saying, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm coming there, you know. Yeah, for all the viewers, audience, when I say that, you know, just these two are the pillars, it means that, yes, they are the foundation. And after, once you have a foundation, you will have a lot more other sub-pillars which are added to maintain it. So we are coming to the sub-pillars part right now. Now, the points that you mentioned, I'm really happy that you actually immediately took their names, because that's extremely crucially should be recognized and needed in any movie. Because I know the drill that when we were shooting for my movie, it's a thriller suspense one, ghostly movie. So we have to shoot the whole nights. Every day it's a night movie. Forget about we actors. We used to come like, you know, having the mosquito. What is that? This is something which doesn't bite the mosquito, right? We used to put, cream and then just come for that bits. And again, you know, put all the blankets so they don't kill us. But all this, other people, the post-production, production designers, you know, all the whole team, like, you know, DOP, all of them, they were setting the location for 2-3 hours before us, you know, and they worked so hard. And after the editing, as you said, you know, for something you shot in such a crucial lighting, even for you, you shot so many things in dark. To have that visible in editing is such a tough task. So it's like they give life. So, you know, it's like they all people are the ones, background music, we cannot even ignore that. Especially for suspense thrillers, I'm sure you also are on the same page. They're also crucial, I'm sure. That's why you also worked hard to pick the best team, right? But at the same time, it's a little bit, you know, everywhere. Always people, the actors, the directors get the main. It's not like everyone has a fair share. The facing the screen always have that little extra advantage because the audience have to view it.
Well, if it bombs, I think that the blame solely rests on the director. So, you know, so it's fair enough that he gets the lion's share of the thing as well, right? So, what was your question? Sorry, you were asking a question and I cut it.
No. My question is that what better way these people also become more into the limelight or famous? What is your strategy on that? Because in future, he also will become the director. How do you plan, like, you know, these other talents which has, you know, starting from story writers and a lot of people, right? Because I'll tell you one comment recently I have, because I started this talk show as a actress to actors, right? I approached a writer and I said that, hey, I wanted to talk show with you because you're important. You know what he said? Ma'am, who is going to watch a writer's interview or a talk show? You know, people will be really interested to watch us or listen to us. And this was just 1 week ago. And I was shocked. I'm like, what? Yours is number one film right now. And then why are you even saying that? They're like, no, I just thought that way. I said, no, you are indirectly the hero of the movie. You should come with confidence. So I see that there is some kind of holding back with the rest of the crew. So what is your share of thought on that? I mean,
not just the names that I mentioned, right? There are others in the team, like Raghu. I mean, he was my line producer. He's, the hardest working person on the set, right? And many others, right? I mean, it took this village to make Gatham.
Yes.
Right? And we were blessed that I'll tell you, right? I mean, after that 14-day shoot we had in Tahoe, I went back home and I missed the setting. I missed being on sets.
Really?
The first 2 days, and you know, and we came back on December 31st. What do you do on December 31st? You are in a party mood.
In a party mood, yeah.
But still, I missed being on the sets. That's how much we became a family.
Family, yep.
It's so you're right. I mean, it's each and every person is important. So I think, you know, for Gatham, right, we got recognized by an outfit in Hyderabad. You know, there was an award function, you know, and they called all these, you know, films which didn't have the mainstream actors, if you will, right? I mean, the nowadays mainstream actors. And they called it Golden Cape Awards. And they recognized everybody. Right, editor, you know, line producer, executive producer, producer, everybody, right? It takes a team, right? So everyone there got a golden cape. They are the superhumans and the superheroes of the film.
I love that. How
the you know, so
that is wonderful. I'm so glad you mentioned that, because we need more of that kind of organizations, right? Who recognize everybody, and then that's awesome. I mean, thanks for mentioning that. I mean, I didn't even know. So that feels great. The next question I would like to discuss is that, again, many people, because I keep meeting so many people in the United States, I keep going to so many events as a chief guest. A lot of people in the backstage ask, ma'am, if I really need to approach you, I don't even know if you're making any movie, how can I be part of it? I'm like, oh, I posted on my Facebook or my page. They're like, but not everyone has an access to connect it to you directly, right? So how do we even know that there are casting calls happening or opportunities happening? And this is a fair question so many people ask. And I keep thinking myself too, what is the best way? I mean, with so much of social media existing, Google, Facebook, God knows what all. How do we bring people close to each other? Have any thoughts on that? How do you want
this
to?
This is a tough nut. Yeah, absolutely. And it's a very valid question. It's a very important question. And I'm not sure I can solve it right now, or anybody can solve it in one go. I don't think there is a right or wrong answer for this. We struggled. Casting was a big pain for us, big problem for us. In retrospect, we got lucky. Okay. But casting, it is the lifeline of a film, right? I mean, you need to, you don't get the emotions and the vision of the director out, then it won't work, basically, isn't it? So casting is very important. Not just casting, even looking for the right crew, cinematographer, very important, right? Yep. Focus puller, right? AC1, AC2, AD1, AD2, all these supporting staff and cast, very important. And we happen to find it through Production Hub, Craigslist, posting it on Insta or in Facebook, social media, Twitter, etc. That's what we did. But I think it's about time that somebody solved this as a platform for us, on as a platform, it's like a Production Hub or something, but just aimed at Telugu cinema industry, or Hindi's, divided by languages, category wise, language categories, even geography, if you want. And say my preference is, I can only act, I'm on an H1 or whatever, right? My limitations, I can only act in US, I can't go to India. However, I want to act in Telugu movies. That should be a preferable look, and all the castings go there. I can apply for auditions, or apply, send my whatnot show reels, etc. But I think that is something that there's this guy I worked with on a short film which never saw the light of day, but I think he's coming up with a platform for exactly this.
Oh, nice. Yeah, do share, in my next talk shows or something, we can absolutely make it more reachable to more people. With so much of information out there these days, it gets difficult which is the right one to choose.
That is why Google is in business.
It is not in business. It took over all businesses.
Exactly.
So put it that way.
Yeah.
All right. So let's move on to our next segment of, I want to do something surprise for you, which you never expected at all. So will you be ready for your surprise?
Depends on what it is.
So you're excited, Bhargav? You are?
Safe to say, yeah.
Yes. Okay. The surprise is your wife, Sunita.
Oh, wow. Okay. That is the first time I'm on an interview along with her. So yeah. Oh, boy.
See, you need to really bring people on who actually are supported behind scenes, right? Without her, I'm sure nothing is possible. So she needs the limelight, and she needs the recognition of for who you are. So I thought, let me do the surprise for Marga.
Yeah, I mean, for my story, she's the hero. So let me put it that way.
See, you gained the points from all the viewers now. Hi. Oh my God, I see you.
Yes,
oh my God, that's so good. Bhargav is all blushing. He is So Sunita, please, I'm so honored and feeling very nice that you're here with me on my talk show here. And I'm also in San Francisco in Bay Area. So it's a, one of the unique guests where we are all in the same location. So it feels good to have here. So how do you feel about your husband's journey in acting? I know, I'm sure you sacrificed a lot, you supported a lot. Otherwise, there's no way these things can be done by a single person in a family. So please share your thoughts here.
Yeah, I'm very happy that he's able to do what he wants, and we have come a long way. So yeah, I'm very happy for him.
I can see all the happiness in your face. You know, you have a beautiful smile.
Right. Yeah. I mean, she. I keep telling it everywhere. She's a woman of few words. So, but you're right. I mean, Thank you. Thank you for bringing her on. My success, my journey, or whatever success we had with Gautam and whatever we did, it's only possible because of the support that I got from Sunita. You know, having two kids. This kid is Samba. And he's the younger one, right? He's 12 years old. I have a 16-year-old kid. So having two kids is more than a full-time parent's job. So Sunita takes care of all of that so that I can go and do, you know, whenever I have these acting gigs, I'm able to do it like, you know, free mind. And, you know, I'm able to. So, you know, for me,
wow.
It doesn't get limelight, but, you know, that's how it works, I guess. But
Yes. Absolutely. One person in the family has to help. So Sunita, you know, Samba, I was about to come back to you. And hi, Samba.
Hi.
Sunita, anything else that you would like to tell to the audience or to your husband? Good wishes.
Yeah. So he's actually very nice. Whenever he gets time, he spends a lot of time with us. And then he does a lot of help also. Yeah.
No, all the credit goes to you, Sunita. Hands down, I'm telling you, not just because I need to tell as a woman to woman. All the credit goes to you for a lot of stuff. I mean, like, you know, I think his success is your success. It's all because of you. So I think you should feel really proud of whatever you're doing to him. So yeah, I always believe in woman power.
Yeah, enter into this. Like, I'm blessed with sweet kids, so they're also really helpful. So it's very easy to maintain even when he's out. So yeah, it's all like we all are into this together.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for coming and, you know, giving this, making this surprise success for me.
Yeah.
Hopefully we'll get the
idea. I got the name as the producer, but she's the person in the home who makes the judgment on the right scripts. So seriously, right? Any script I get, I make her read it. And she gives her perspective. That's when I get, like the next film I'm doing, right? That was her call, right?
Oh my God. Awesome.
She's my sounding board for everything, if you will.
Awesome. I'm so proud of you, Sunita. Thank you. Thank you for doing all this, bringing this talent out, and all the credit goes to you. Hopefully I get to meet you soon in person. Nice talking to you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you.
Bye, Samba. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Sunita. Hey. So that's my share of surprise for you, Bhargav. I'm so happy.
Yeah,
you know, sometimes.
Awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. Getting them on board, it's a special feeling.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. So let's go to the last round, which is the rapid fire.
Okay.
No, very few questions. Given a choice. Actor or director, which one did you choose? Assume that you got an option that you could be a lead actor, but you also got the chance to be a director. Which one would you choose?
I would do both.
You would like to do both?
Yeah, I'll direct myself.
I'll remember that if I come to you with a script.
Absolutely. I mean, but at the end of the day, if I fit the role, then I can direct myself. So at least I believe I can direct myself. So why not, right? I mean, I think there are many people who have done it successfully. I think it's a feasible thing.
You know, Ajay Devgan does that multiple zillion number of times.
Yeah,
and all his movies were hits. So it's absolutely.
Yeah, love his films. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. If you had to do a shooting in United States, or India, which would you prefer? Assume that in India it's with a big banner and big hero collaboration, and here is something like Gatham, independent movie, and the dates clashed. What would you choose?
Tough one. I think I would probably go with the big banner one in India, because I'm being very practical here, right?
Yeah.
However, if you ask me, I will make the big banner guys come and do it in US, because I keep telling in whatever interviews I did so far, I told in almost all of them, US has not been exploited. It's not been exploited the way we should for actually film, you know, telling a story. All Telugu cinemas they have done so far is use them for songs or, you know, some stuff like that. It's a backdrop. In between a story, they come to US and go back, right? You know, hey, we've done this travel sort of thing. So it's more of a glamour thing, but other than not enhancing the story. Gatham, if you look at it, the locale actually fed into the story and the story fed into the locale, if you will. It's a spine-chilling psychological thriller. Guess what? It's in snow, middle of nowhere. Just added to that aura, right? So I think US, as such, has a lot of locations like that that haven't been used at all, right? It's a huge country, blessed really with these landscapes. So it can be used for good storytelling. It hasn't been exploited even 1%. I think Gatham is the first movie. And hopefully we'll have many, many more to come. I mean, we saw Nishabdam, but I really don't know, I mean, how much it's a good start is what Nishabdam is. I think we have to build on Nishabdam, and Gatham I did really well.
That's a great, great answer that you gave. Exactly what in my mind too, that either through NRIs, NRI talent, or the locations, I think it's not explored to the 100% level. I mean, like, unless there is some weather conditions or something which is not available in India, been here. I think a lot of movies like Gatham is like actually one of the inspiration start for people to look back to United States and saying that, hey, this kind of independent movies can be done. And a lot of people started thinking towards it, right? As a full-fledged movies. So you guys are like kind of like a game changer or trend changers, if I need to say that.
I have talked to maybe 10, 15 filmmakers afterwards who said the same thing. Hey guys, you gave us a shot in the arm. We're truly, you know, really gives every dreams that were like getting dormant, right? Spark.
Yeah.
We want to do it now. So a lot of people are calling us up and asking how we did it. And I am helping everybody out, right? I want more and more filmmakers in the US to come up. And it's not just about being US or anything like that. It's not that. I just genuinely feel that there is locale here, the beauty here that you can use for storytelling. Now, the next film that I'll be producing, I'm actually acting in that. We will be announcing it soon. It's in Kakinada. Okay.
Oh, now the whole story.
Everything is in Kakinada. The story dictates that, isn't it? So if there is a story that can be told in the US, it can be told very well. So that's what
I'm thinking of. Got it. Understood. That's a great answer. And I love that. Okay. So the one more last rapid fire question. So do you prefer glamour roles or more character roles? Because I'll tell you the difference here before you answer is, it's not everybody's cup of tea to do romance. It's not everybody's cup of tea to do the real character roles to bring that elements out. But an actor is an actor, should be able to do anything. But what you prefer is you choose. Would you choose? If you are given an option on both, which kind of things would you choose?
I really don't care. To me, honestly, I don't care. For me, it's a challenge in the role. If me as an actor, if I question myself, can I even pull it off, right? Then that's a role I'm willing to, accept the challenge. As you said, romance is a hard thing. It's very hard. At my age, with, whatever limitations I have, pulling it off on screen, can I even do it? Yeah, that's a challenge. I would love to try it. But there are many other challenges. Like for Gatham, I had to show my emotional side. There is a complex, it's a dichotomy, two characters into one, very complex character. That's a challenge very few people get to take. And I just relished it. You know, so any challenge, anything challenging, I definitely would love to do it. Anything, there's no subject that's taboo for me. You know, I'll go to any extent, any role, I'll do it if it's challenging enough and if there is impact.
That's a true passion for acting, right?
Yep.
All right, sounds good. It was great talking to you. And before we sign off, is there anything that you would like to tell to the audience? Because now that you have a name, and anything that message you pass or you do makes a difference, right? That's all what we do. Like anytime we are a little bit more recognized, the first thing we do is giving back to the community or try to help. What is that message you would like to do that people can follow you or take that as an inspiration?
I am very available. You know, so many people have reached out to me on Instagram and Facebook, countless people, and I almost respond to almost every one of them. It's becoming tedious now because so many people are reaching out and it is taking up time. But I guess I'll keep doing it till, you know, I cannot. I guess at a point in time, I just cannot do it anymore. There is no shortcut. I think a lot of people, it's a very cliched term, there's no shortcut. So you just have to be ready for the grunt work. People see here's the first thing, right? Our first short film which won this award, the judging was done by Harish Shankar of Gabbar Singh fame, Kodan Ramareddy, and Merlapak Gandhi as well. The Tirumala Express, I think you would have seen that. So these are big names in Telugu industry. They saw this thing and they gave it, won the prize. So Harish Shankar was sitting at the judge table, and we all filmmakers, like the short film directors, producers, and, you know, actors and all of them. So Harish Shankar said, I will reverse the role. And he said, I will ask you guys questions instead of you asking me questions. So and he asked me a question, and that this is what the question he asked it. What did you learn after having made one short film? And this is what I told him, right? Before that, I would go to a movie and say, stupid movie, stupid acting, waste fellow, waste director. You know, I could. Like, there will be some movies I would do that too, right? Some, like, really good movies, I'd say, oh, I love this movie. But after this short film, I said, I will stop saying, you know, bad things about any filmmaker, any role, because just the amount of effort that goes into making a film is mind-blowing. It's just mind-blowing. Right? You know it, right? It's so hard. People see the Chiranjeevis of the world. People see Allu Arjun. But they work hard.
They work hard too. You see the difference between Allu Arjun's first movie and now. You can't even recognize. He worked really hard.
Every filmmaker, they might throw tantrums. They're super, you know, big film stars or all. But they do work hard. It's a hard job to make films.
It's
hard. So that's my thing to any up and coming. It is a hard job. So, you know, get ready to roll your sleeves up. You know, get dirty and be scrappy, and, you know, push comes to shove, your film got to see the day of light. That's the mentality you have to have when you start filmmaking.
Absolutely. That's a great, great advice. And I'm sure everyone do agree to that 100,000% that we start appreciating every small thing that is out there, you know, before we pass the comment. But absolutely. I think I wish you so much luck, more success, everything, because you know, you work hard, you have the passion to do it, and there are a lot of projects which you already told, the future projects that you're already working on. We look forward to it, for more magic from Marga.
thank you Jo. It is a really different talk show. I as I said, you know, I probably would have been 30, 40 talk shows after Gautam, right? But this is really different. I really, really enjoyed talking to you. And hopefully we'll collaborate more in the future.
Yay, yes. Yes, awesome. Okay, thank you so much, Bhargav. And we'll keep in touch with you and talk to you soon. Thank you, audience, for enjoying our talk show next week for sure. Bye-bye.